Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Thank you for joining us for today's ISS update this Thursday, November 17. Aboard the orbiting complex, the Expedition 29 crew expanded from 3 crew members to 6 crew members. NASA astronaut Dan Burbank and Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin docked their Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft to the Poisk mini-research module late Tuesday night. Station Commander Mike Fossum and Flight Engineers Satoshi Furukawa and Sergei Volkov welcomed their new crewmates after opening the hatches early yesterday morning. After a welcoming ceremony with mission officials and family members, the station residents conducted the standard crew safety briefing. The new crew members have familiarized themselves with the potential hazards, safety equipment locations, and escape routes. The newly arrived trio has now begun its fourth day in space and second day aboard the International Space Station. While the new arrivals settle into their new home, Fossum, Furukawa, and Volkov are in their final stretch aboard the orbiting complex before their departure in the Soyuz TMA-02M spacecraft next week. Fossum, Volkov, and Furukawa launched to the orbiting complex aboard their Soyuz spacecraft as the Expedition 28 crew this summer on June 7. Today, they will complete their 163rd consecutive day in space. Fossum, Furukawa, and Volkov will undock from the Rosviat Mini Research Module and land in Kazakhstan on November 21st at 8:21 p.m. Central Time. Their undocking will start the Expedition 30. After adjusting sleep schedules for the arrival of the new Soyuz and crew members, the crew began its first regular schedule as a six-member crew today with a wake-up at 1 a.m. Central Time. A couple hours after wake-up, the expedition crew participated in the first of two daily planning conferences with ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. Commander Mike Fossum and Flight Engineer Satoshi Furukawa will perform an hour of their two-hour daily scheduled exercise. Fossum will be performing strength training with the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device. After deconfiguring a joint orbital communications adapter router to stow away as a spare onboard the station, Furukawa will work out using the onboard treadmill. Flight Engineer Sergei Volkov will participate in a private medical conference and exercise at the bottom of the hour. Meanwhile, the new Expedition 29 crewmates Dan Burbank and Anton Shkaplerov will familiarize themselves with the exercise equipment on board. The on-orbit gym is equipped with a stationary bicycle, a treadmill, and the advanced exercise device that simulates weightlifting here on Earth. Also, Anatoly Ivanishin will be tending to a Russian cell cultivation experiment known as Cascade. Earlier this morning, Commander Fossum led a crew handover review with his crewmates. As part of this handover, the crew reviewed emergency roles and responsibilities aboard the International Space Station. Fossum then changed out a tank of the onboard water recovery system and also checked on a couple science experiments of the commercial generic bioprocessing apparatus and also the binary colloidal alloy test. Before today's update hour, Fossum tended to the combustion integrated rack, a facility that houses hardware capable of performing combustion experiments there in microgravity. Flight engineer Dan Burbank, shown here in this view, is performed his first reaction self-test that measures fatigue resulting from the disruption of the circadian rhythm while living and working in space. He had also participated in his first private medical conference and an inventory management system and stowage conference there with Mike Fossum, who is also shown in this view. Flight engineer Sergei Volkov documented with photos on an ongoing Russian science experiment known as bioemulsion that aims to provide efficient, ecologically safe production of bacterial, fermental, and medicinal preparations. He also had relocated hardware that was used earlier in another science experiment known as Plasmida that examines the microgravity effect on the rate of transfer on plasmid DNA. Volkov also tended to the cell cultivation experiment as well as an experiment that looks at the growth of wheat in space. Meanwhile, Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin studied the emergency roles and responsibilities of the International Space Station and spent some time adjusting to their new environment in space. While the three new crew members will continue to settle in their new home, work with their station veteran crewmates and additional handovers, and adjust to their microgravity living space. The expedition crew is scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.